اللہ من الشیطان الرجیم بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم نحمدہ و نصلی علی رسول الکریم. لاسٹ ٹائم وی ور ڈسکسنگ آیت نمبر 157 آف سورہ البقرہ. ان فیکٹ سنس لاسٹ اے فیو ویکس وی آر ڈسکسنگ دس آیت اینڈ وی ہیڈ ڈسکسڈ الذین. ٹوڈے وی آر ڈسکسنگ اولائک ویل the last few words of this ayat, and I hope next in a couple of weeks we'll be able to complete it. Now last time when we finished, there were two questions some of our friends asked here. One was about the word Rajun, although we had discussed it, but I will slightly try to clarify it, the question which he raised. And also some other friend raised a question about cause and effect, but I think that I will discuss next time along with ayat number 154 if we have time at the but if you have time today, I'll go into that aspect also. Now, so far as the concept of Raj'un is concerned, it is not only that we have to wait for the time when we have to go back, we die and go back and appear before the Lord. For example, in Surah Al-Fajr, last ayat, Ya ayyatuha an-nafsul mutmainnah, irji ila rabbik. What does that mean? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking in this life to make a rujoo to Him. He is calling to come back to Him even in this life. So it's not that when we die we'll go to Him. Even here we are His make. He has created us. He is the manufacturer. Whatever the defect, He has given us such a super computer, such a super body, such a super make and model, that nobody has been able and nobody will be able to match it. There is no other mechanic where we can take it. We have to, even for a minor the thing, we have to go and submit to Him in this life. We have Rajun applies to both, that is going back to the hereafter, in the hereafter, and also during this period of our existence here. I may try to explain this with a very small example. Even in case of this computer, how many times you get a pop-up that now your update is due? We get a pop-up, now your telephone starts, wants restart. Its restart is due. And you say it in your computer, it asks you, it gives you an option, it gives the option that what time you want the update of your computer, at night at 12 o'clock, in the morning at 10 a.m. or whatever time. Now it is such a world and such a technology which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us, and it's such, there are so many innumerable variables which are interacting all the time, that it needs resetting, it needs updating, it needs sometimes when the computer goes out of order, we are not able to ordinarily repair it, you restore the original settings, you come back to the default settings, and that is how you reset it. In our case, the human being's computer is most supercomputer. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us the direction that I have made you, I know when you need the update, come back for resetting it 5 times a day. Reset it, it will take only a couple of minutes. Reset it and you then get yourself busy with your work. It is good for you, to save you from the tensions, from the viruses, from the viral attacks, from the satanic attacks, whatever unwanted cookies or macros have been deposited on your computer, you just come for a couple of minutes and reset yourself, and it gives you a lot of relief. So this is what is required in Rajun. in this life, we have to go back and submit to Him every time to reset. Whenever you take a turn on your wheel in the car, you have to again bring it back in the same position in the right direction. Otherwise, if you leave it in the turn position, it will just be whirling. Now, same is the case with the final return journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are many concepts of time. Wal asr al insan al fi khusr. This is the major concept. I have explained it in detail in Know Your God, that every tick of time, the world agrees, all the scientists agree, that one day this world is going to end, this universe is going to end. And every tick of time is a khasr, it is a loss, it is a minus, it is a deduction from the total life, ajalim musamma, which has been given to us. It has been given to the earth, it has been given to the solar system, or it has been given to the universe. There is every tick of time is a minus, is a khasr. Now, there are different concepts of time. For example, some scientists have explained it that it's an arrow of time moving in one direction. Others say, no, it is like a bale. It's bale-shaped theory. It's a theory. And then others have explained in that's like a flower, that its petals are opening. And the theory of Big Bang also, to some extent, accepts that the petals of forces, gravity and other forces, they in sequence they unfolded. And even the cyclical concepts of time, like the Egyptian, they had cyclical concept of time, the Chinese, the Indians, but all these concepts ultimately agree on one point. That is, there is an end to the universe, there is an end to the world, there is end to the life, this life we are here. Rajun, we are in the process of going back. And in this process of going back, when we ultimately go there, at that time it's not a question of repair. At that time it is the question of final settlement of account. If we want repair, if we want to reset it, if we want to reset the direction, then we have to make ruju now. Irji'i ila rabbik. Come, I mean pleased, and I'll be pleased with you. I am pleased with you. Come back to me. So this is the concept of Rajun in this world and in the hereafter. The second question was about the cause and effect. I think that I'll take up along with ayat number 154, that I try to complete this today. Now, ulaik means they. Who are these people? Those who have submitted to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that yes, we are raji'un to you. In this world also, we come back to you. Hazrat Ibrahim alayhi salam said that I am going to back to my Lord and He will guide me. So if we are such people, ulaik, if we are like Him, that we are submitting to Him, that we come to Him every time for resetting, for even for a minor defect, even for a minor mistake, even for our follies, even for our sins, we come back to Him, He is welcoming. He simply says that come willingly, I am willing to accept you. Now, like for them, this is now a very important concept which is coming up. Like alayhim salawatun min rabbihim. You contrast it with another statement in the Quran, ulaik ala hudam min rabbihim. What is the difference? But here it says ulaik alayhim salawatun min rabbihim wa ulaik humul muhtadun. So what is the difference? There must be some difference. Ulaik ala hudam min rabbihim. At that place, in the context of those ayat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that they are on the path, they are in the process, where they are being guided. They are seeking my guidance, I am guiding them. Even if they are not seeking my guidance, I am guiding them. they are being guided on that sirat, on that path, and that path they are coming to me. But here there's something different. It says ulaika humul muhtadun. These are the people who have already reached that stage that they are no more simply being guided, but they have adopted a quality, an attribute, an ingrained character that they are muhtadun. This is the difference, that they have consciously, unconsciously, in the depth of their conscious, they have ingrained themselves, they are muhtadun, they are hidayat yafta, they are the people. Now a noun is being used, a participle is being used, that they are muhtadun, and they are on the path of hidayat, in that translation, in that interpretation. But here they have become ingrained. For example, at one place Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that my color is the best color. When you sibghat Allah, when you adopt the sibghat Allah, here this is, that is the position, that when you adopt Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's hidayat, that reflects in your character, in your color. And at one place Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that their signs on their face, you will find that they reflect their character. But we simply translate as if there is somebody has a sign here of sujood. Asar is sujood. Asar is sujood creates an awe in the character, some glare in the character, that you will find that yes, he is a good man. He is reflecting the attributes of God. He has adopted those attributes in himself, that now Sibghat Allah is glaring, is glittering. So this is the stage where you look at the construction of this muhtadun. It's a participle. It is not just going on the path, but it is when you have adopted the asar sujood, you have adopted the sibghat Allah, you have adopted the attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in yourself, and one of his most important connection, that is hidayat for the muttaqeen. All these things are reflected here, and that is the participle. When you are muhtadun, it's all in plural. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing in plural here, in a community, a state, an ummah. Now, what are the privileges then? This is the state. Muhtadun is the state of the person which he has adopted, to which he has developed himself. Then what are his privileges? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that ulaika alayhim salawatun. Alayhim salawatun. Same words used differently. Sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Sallu alayhi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that all the celestial bodies in the universe, in the solar system, in the heavens, everybody, everything knows its salat and tasbih. It's not, they are not reading anything on tasbih as we do here on the rosary. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says they know their salat. So what is the meaning of salat? Salat has many meanings, but it's every meaning and every connotation of any word in Arabic in Quran has to be linked to the root. The root from which these meanings come up, it refers to the activity, to the warmth, to the function. How we perform salat, we didn't know when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked that the Muslims should perform namaz, salat. The Prophet, peace be upon him, showed us the way, and we offer it the way. We offer that function, we perform that function the way he told us. Similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the way the celestial bodies have to function, it is ingrained in them. They function as they have been asked. They perform their function as they have been asked. It is an activity. It is there is a warmth in that activity. It is a synchronized activity. Any activity which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given to anybody, it has some synchronization with some relation with the other bodies. And even within itself, it has a symmetry. It has a sequence. It has a science. So it is not without reference to its root. All the roots from where the Arabic words emanate, they have a science. In every syllable, in every word, in every harf, there is a science in it, a meaning in it. Now, the root word, the root meaning shows that the function is in such a manner where our Mufassireen have explained it with some examples, that when two camels run together in a race, competing, catching each other, and they run neck to neck, step with step, one following the other from behind closely. And in that effort, they are in fact helping each other that they give the best performance. In competition, you always give the best performance. It is not singular. That is why it has been asked, the address is always in the plural. You can perform salat at your home also. But when you come with the congregation, when you come with the ummah, when you come with the community, it's not only a question of competition, it is a question of excelling. Excelling your interaction and excelling your own community, your own selves, and interacting with each other, and in that interaction you create the excellence. Now here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying that my salat, salawat are on them. What is this salat which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending on us? What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking when he says that sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Sallu alayhi means you follow the Prophet from behind with all the reverence in obedience closely, so that all his movements, his revolution, his mission is accomplished in the most excellent manner. Sallu alayhi. It's not just sitting here and counting on the rosary that I have sent 5 million durood. That's very good. For the purpose of sawab, okay. At one place I went to a madrasa, they had about 5,000 or more, even more, students in madrasa. And they told me that every day they have an exercise from morning to the evening, and in that exercise they are performing, they are giving more than 5 million durood every day. Now if we calculate all this, there are crores of durood which we perform every day. But still we are in this situation. It means something else is also required. We have to perform something. We have to do something. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking for some function. Sallu alayhi. Follow the Prophet, peace be upon him, in his word and deed, so that his mission is fulfilled. Now, when we were child, you must have seen, and even as grown-up children, even as adolescents, you must have observed, but as children, you must be observing your children also. The mother never turns her eye from the infant, from the child. She keeps eye on every movement of her child. What he needs, how he moves, is he falling down, how is he taking the step. Whatever the child is doing, the infant is doing, the child is doing, mother, particularly mother, even father, but particularly mother, her eye never turns away from the infant. And she knows what he needs, what he or she needs, at what time, what he needs. Sallu alayhi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps track, closely following, from the above. Like the GPS, when you are muhtadun, wherever you are in USA, you are in India, you are in Pakistan, you are in Egypt, wherever you are, sallu alayhi. His eyes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Nuh alayhi salam, that you build the boat before my eyes. I want to see you. I'll watch you. I'm watching you. I'm seeing you. He is Sami. He is Basir. When we say Allah, then in this one word are combined all the Asma'ul Husna. None of the names, no one name stands alone. And it cannot be explained stand alone. They are all in continuum. When he is Khalik, he is Rahman also. When he is Khalik, he is Rahim also. When he is Khalik, he is Kareem also. All these are together. He is Sami also. He is Basir also. So here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, using the word Rububiyat, that in his Rububiyat, all these functions of Razak, he is Razak, he is Khalik, he is maintainer, he is developer, he gives, provides the money sense, he is the providence, he is everything which he, which is maintaining the universe. He is using the word Rabb, that as your maintainer, as your controller, as your developer, as your cherisher, as your manager, I am all the time keeping an eye on you, looking you, I am with you, I am above you, I am over you, I am with you. Step in step, you go, I am with you. My salawat, like sallu alayhi, I am with you. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, salawat alayhim, alayhim salawat min rabbihim. Very, lovingly. That his salawat are on you, on those who are muhtadin, and who are the muhtadin who have accepted that, yes, for even a small accident, even for any small sin, or if any mistake, or any whatever damage I have caused, I come back to you. And he is tawab. Whatever time you go, he returns to you. He returns to us. And he is pleased whenever you go back to him. I think this is, I stop here. And so far as the other question is, so cause and effect, I may take up with along with ayat 154 next time. If there is any question.
We still have about 10 minutes. So
okay. Then I think I move to... The next ayat was 154, which I had proposed that I'll take up. I open that. I'll just introduce, and then if anything remains, we can take up next time. Where is 154? Wala takulu لَمَنْ يُقْتَلُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتِ بَلْ أَحْيَا وَلَكِنْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَالنَّقْصِ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Now in this ayat, particularly in these words, khawf, hunger, and losses, in these three words, all the wars in the world which have taken place, the World War II, World War I, and the drums about the Third World War which are being played, or 100 years war, or 30 years war in Europe, and all other wars, all other revolutions, and all the development of sciences, physical sciences particularly, they revolve around these three words. But we have gone so deep into that we interpret, we understand that what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling it, and then he brings us to the point that you are for me, inna lillahi wa inna ilahi rajoon. Now, I think before I explain this khauf, what is khauf? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repeated these words here in this sequence? Well, khauf and jū and the losses. These three things. All the wars and all the revolutions and all the scientific development has taken place around these three words. Now, I take up just one word. I go to khauf. But after that, I'll discuss this. Is it okay?
Yeah, it's okay. We still have 6:58, and we in general.
But in 5 minutes, it will not finish.
No,
this will.
If we don't finish, maybe we can continue. But I just want to mention something. Brother Masoud has his two sisters. I think one of them is from California.
Yeah,
I see. Dr. Muhammadi and Dr. Basim are actually joining us today. And I know Dr. Muhammadi, I think Brother Masoud used to send some of my writing to you.
Yes.
That's true. So you are welcome here, and we're glad you can make it.
No, if she wants to speak, she can come here. I'll come back there, and she can come here.
No, you stay. They might ask you a question.
I say, but she can come near here. You can use the mic.
Thank you.
Okay, that's fine. They will ask you next time. They will prepare a question for you, a deeper question for you, but they have to listen to you first for the first time. Anybody has any question for Mrs. Cicero?
Well, he was going to go after him whatever time he had.
Well, okay, I think we have only about 5 minutes, so he's not going to do justice.
No, this will not be finished in 5 minutes. This will take at least 2 to 3lectures.
Allahumma salli wa sallim wa barik ala Sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وعافنا فيمن عافيت وتوب لنا فيمن توليت وبارك اللهم لنا فيما اعطيت وقنا واصرف عنا شر ما قضيت انك يا ربنا تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك وباركت ربنا وتعاليت لك الحمد على ما قضيت نستغفرك ربنا ونتوب اليك اللهم ادخلنا برحمتك في عبادك الصالحين اللهم اخرجنا من ظلمات الجهل والوهم الى نور العلم اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما اللهم اجعلنا ممن يستمعون القول فيتبعون احسنه اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك وبطاعتك عن معصيتك وفضلك عن من سواك اللهم بفضلك ورحمتك على كلمه الحق والدين اللهم انصر الاسلام وعز المسلمين يا اكرم الاكرمين يا الله او الله spread your mercy upon us shower us with your blessing increase our knowledge grant us forgiveness and reward us with the company of the prophets in the firdaus al-a'la او الله purify our heart strengthen our faith our knowledge and make us benefit from what you have taught us. O Allah, forgive our parents and all the believers and grant them the Firdaus al-A'la. O Allah, remedy our sick and grant them full and speedy recovery. O Allah, guide our children, protect them and make them righteous. O Allah, guide us to be always a source of peace and security for our people. O Allah, guide our citizens, our fellow citizens, to truth and to guide their hearts to Islam. O Allah, we ask you every name you have elected for yourself, that none of us leave this gathering, but his pains have been relieved, his worries have been removed, his debts have been paid, his weaknesses have been concealed, his sins have been forgiven, and his needs have been fulfilled. Subhanallah wa bihamdih, adada khalqi wa rida nafsi wa zinat arshi wa midada kalimati. سبحان الله وبحمده عدد خلق ورضا نفسه وزينة عرشه ومداد كلماته سبحان الله وبحمده عدد خلق ورضا نفسه وزينة عرشه ومداد كلماته والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على خير المرسلين اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.